Welcome. In this small video, I will discuss about one-time passwords using challenge response. In password authentication, the user authenticates himself or herself using a secret that the user knows, which is his or her password. But this password, if it is compromised, then the adversary or the attacker can log into the system anytime using this password. In challenge response authentication system, the user proves that he or she knows a secret without that secret going on the meeting. So in challenge response system, we generate a password which is called as OTP, one-time passwords. This OTP will change every time it is used, meaning that if there are any intercepted passwords, they will not be useful because they cannot be reused. The system, instead of assigning a static password phrase for a user, assigns a static mathematical function. Let's see. For example, if this side we have a user Alice who tries to authenticate herself to this verifier Bob or server Bob, she will send her identity to this verifier. This verifier Bob will send a challenge to her, let's say for example a number X, and to this challenge this user Alice has to respond with a proper f of X. This function of X is a pre-decided function between this user and the verifier. So these are some of the examples of the possible functions which this user and Bob, the authenticator or verifier, can have pre-decided. For example, f of x is equals to x of x plus 1, or f of x is equals to sum of digits in number x. For example, if the number x is 123, then this f of x will be 1 plus 2 plus 3 equals to 6. Or f of x can be any other function, like I have given here example 3x square minus 9x plus 2, or any other function also. Or f of x can be equals to px, where px is the xth prime number. So like this, if you have a person authenticating himself or herself to a server, then we have to use these functions which are simple enough to be computed by the users. But if we have a machine-to-machine authentication, then we can also use encryption functions like DES or AES, because then they will be more appropriate. So here I show one example how we can use encryption as one-time password. So Alice, when she wants to authenticate, she sends her ID to this verifier Bob. Bob throws a random number to Alice, RB, and this RB, the random number, Alice will encrypt with a shared secret key between Alice and Bob, represented by KAB. So Bob can verify whether the user Alice has responded correctly to the challenge by decrypting this using this key KAB. I expect the students to implement this kind of one-time password scheme using challenge response in this manner. On this side, we have several users who are trying to authenticate themselves to this server Bob. This server Bob will store a pre-decided table of user functions, a different function for each user. For example, let's say Alice, it stores a function called sum of digits. For another user, Charlie, it stores a reverse of a number, and so on for various users. This implementation can be done in any programming language of student's choice. The communication between these users and server Bob can be implemented in the form of socket program. So every user will first give his or her identity to this server. The server will throw a challenge in the form of throwing a number X, and that user, depending on this predefined function, has to respond correctly. If a user responds correctly, he will be authenticated. If the response is incorrect, the user authentication will fail. Thank you very much.